Hello friends, so today we are going to learn new topic called economic value added. So this is the video number 7 and first video for economic value added. We can check out economic value added. What is this concept is? Firstly, we'll try to understand the definition of this concept. Economic value added is the economic profit by the company in a given period. It measures the company's financial performance based on residual wealth calculated by deduction of cost of capital from its operating profit adjusted for tax on cash basis. So first of all, check out the first line. Economic value added is the economic profit of the company in a given period. Now, economic profit, what that concept is? The concept of economic profit. Now, every company every year earn the profit. But now, for example, suppose I am earning the profit. But if I entire my profit is spending on the distribution of various cost of capital, or after the distribution of cost of capital, if nothing is left in my hand for the purpose of reinvestment, so I cannot say that there is an economic profit. It means, for example, suppose this year I have earned the profit of rupees 1 lakh, which is a profit after tax. From profit after tax, suppose if I am paying, I am distributing dividend of rupees 60,000, after that what will happen? Rupees 40,000 will become my retained earnings. Means that 40,000 will remain with me and that will be added to the capital. It means my net worth or my capital will increase by rupees 40,000 this year. Even though I have achieved the turnover of rupees lakhs of rupees, but finally my capital will increase only by rupees 40,000 because that much amount only has been transferred to my capital. So when I compare my capital as on today and capital of last year, so you will find the increase in capital by rupees 40,000. It means my net worth has increased by rupees 40,000 and that is economic profit. Means economically my actual wealth has increased by 40,000 even though my turnover is in lakhs of rupees or crores of rupees, but my wealth has ultimately increased by rupees 40,000. Take another example. Suppose I have earned the profit after tax of rupees 1 lakh. An entire 1 lakh has been distributed by way of a dividend. So obviously after the payment of dividend, nothing has left in my hand. So nothing has been added to my wealth. So from economic point of view, there is no profit. Whatever profit I have earned, firstly that profit has been utilized for the payment of expenses, operating expenses, after that tax, and after that obligation of supplier of finances, that is cost of capital. Means my entire profit has been, my profit after tax has totally been utilized for the payment of cost of capital only. So after the payment of cost of capital, nothing has left to my hand to add to my net worth. So there is no economic profit. And this concept says that actually there should be an economic profit. So that's why it measures the company's financial performance based on the residual wealth. For example, just I will take one layman example. Suppose I am earning salary of rupees 50,000 per month. And after, suppose my total monthly expenses are rupees 10,000, including each and everything. And after that, there is a saving of rupees 10,000, which I am investing somewhere. So what will happen? Even though I am earning rupees 50,000 as a salary every month, but my wealth will increase by rupees 10,000 only. So that 10,000 is my economic profit. And the same concept here we are applying. Suppose out of rupees 50,000, if entire amount I am spending on my expenses, my household expenses, my luxury and all those expenses, nothing is remaining in my hand. So even though I am having 50,000 as a profit every month, but still nothing is going to be added to my wealth. मेरी उससे वेल्थ चेंज नहीं होने वाली है, एंड दैट्स व्हाई वी शुड हैव द इकोनॉमिक प्रॉफिट, एंड दैट्स व्हाई दिस सेज दैट दिस प्रॉफिट हाउ इट इज कैलकुलेटेड, इट इज कैलकुलेटेड बाय द डिडक्शन ऑफ कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल फ्रॉम इट्स ऑपरेटिंग प्रॉफिट. सो फ्रॉम ऑपरेटिंग प्रॉफिट वी हैव टू डिडक्ट कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल. सो आफ्टर डिडक्टिंग द कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल वॉट एवर विल रिमेन दैट विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज इकोनॉमिक वैल्यू एडिशन. Now, first of all, operating profit. What do you mean by operating profit? Just see here. Operating profit, which also we call it as a EBIT, earnings before interest and tax, is equal to sales minus operating expenses. Sales minus operating expenses. Now, operating expenses means what? Direct operating expenses and indirect operating expenses, that is purchases, labor, wages, transportation, manufacturing expenses, administration expenses, and selling and distribution expenses. Other than these expenditure, nothing will be deducted from sales to find out the operating profit. Already in the last semester in the ratio analysis, we have seen the difference between net profit and operating profit. Operating profit is a profit which has been earned by way of from your operations. So that's why only we consider the operational revenue. Here we are considering only the sales. Suppose even though I am having some other income, say for example income from investment, say dividend received, interest received, or even profit on sale of asset, those profits, those income we are not considering, because that is not our operational income, that is not our recurring income, that is not our ordinary income. So what is our ordinary income or recurring income? That is our my operation, that is a sales. So sales through my operations minus operating expenses means expenses which are related to my operations only. Expenses which are not related to my operations, we are not going to consider. For example, loss by theft, loss by accident, loss by fire, goodwill written off, preliminary expenses written off, loss on sale of asset. So these type of items we are not deducting even things. Even we are also not deducting interest from operating expenses. Operating expenses doesn't include the finance cost, because interest is a finance cost that will come after the operating expenses. Operating expenses means only manufacturing expenses, administration expenses, selling and distribution expenses. Interest will not be considered as an operating expenditure, so that will come. So from sales, we will deduct only the operating expenses, then we will get operating profit. So for example, but here we want operating profit after tax that we discuss. So from operating profit after tax, operating profit adjusted for tax means operating profit after tax means what? Operating profit minus tax. For example, if my operating profit is say rupees 100, tax rate is say 30%, so tax will be 30. So 100 minus 30, my operating profit will be 70. So this is my operating profit. From this profit, I have not deducted interest. I have deducted only manufacturing cost, administration cost, and selling and distribution cost. So here check out, calculated, it is calculated by deduction of cost of capital. Cost of capital means we are talking about overall cost of capital or weighted average cost of capital from its operating profit adjusted for tax. Means from operating profit after tax, I have to deduct cost of capital. Means cost of debt, cost of preference share, and cost of equity capital. Combinedly, we call it as a overall cost of capital or weighted average cost of capital, which we have already learned in the last semester. That video is already there on the YouTube and on the same channel under the chapter cost of capital. So the total cost of capital I have to deduct from my operating profit after tax, and after deducting that cost, if something is left, that will be my true profit, that will be my economic profit. And through this concept, we have to find out how much, whether that firm is earning the economic profit or not. And if it is earning, how much economic profit it is earning, that we have to calculate. So accordingly, now you can see there are three components of EVA. One is net profit after tax, net operating profit after tax. Just we have seen operating profit means sales minus operating expenses, and operating profit after tax means operating profit minus tax. Secondly, second component is capital invested, and third component is weighted average cost of capital. We call it as WACC. Now look at the formula. This is the formula of EVA. That is a net operating profit after tax minus capital invested into weighted average cost of capital. So this is the formula: net operating profit after tax minus capital invested into weighted average cost of capital. So that's why these are the three components: net operating profit after tax, capital invested, and weighted average cost of capital. So firstly, net operating profit after tax means that is a operating profit before tax minus tax is equal to operating profit after tax. So net operating cash profit into 1 minus tax rate. And operating profit means sales minus indirect operating expense, or in another way you can call it as gross profit minus indirect operating expenses. Either sales minus total operating expenses or gross profit minus indirect operating expenses. Second component is capital invested, that is equity plus debt, or indirectly we call it as a capital employed. Equity means what? Equity is equal to equity capital plus preference capital plus reserves and surplus minus losses. Whereas debt means long term borrowed funds. So these are the equity and debt, which also we have already learned in the last semester in the topic ratio analysis. So combinedly, equity plus debt, it's called as a capital invested or capital employed. And third component is weighted average cost of capital, which is also called as finance charge. So that is equal to cost of debt into debt upon total capital plus cost of equity into equity upon total capital. This also we have learned in the last semester in the cost of capital chapter. But what ultimately it is, this is a specific cost of capital into proportion of debt on total capital. Say for example, say cost of debt is say 10%. Cost of debt is 10%. Amount of debt is rupees 1 lakh and total capital is rupees 5 lakhs. So 1 lakh divided by 5 lakhs, it means that debt is a 20% of total capital. It means the proportion of debt is 0.2. Cost of debt is a 10%. So 10 into 0.2, that comes to 2%. Same like that plus cost of equity. Cost of equity into equity divided by total capital. So that is nothing but the proportion of equity or weight of equity, which are multiplying with cost of equity. Already we have solved the examples in the last semester. Even though that video is available on YouTube channel in the same channel. So this is cost of debt, or cost of debt into weight of debt plus cost of into equity into weight of equity, and total will be weighted average cost of capital. So ultimately it is very easy. Economic value added is equal to net operating profit after tax minus capital invested into weighted average cost of capital. To understand this in better manner, we will see one simple example, example number one. Check out, this is the example. Three things are given to you. One is the income statement, second one is a balance sheet, and third one is cost of capital. Check out what is available in income statement. Revenue rupees 2 lakhs minus operating expenses rupees 1 lakh. So operating profit is equal to 1 lakh. Sales 2 lakhs minus total operating expenses 1 lakh. Operating profit is equal to 1 lakh. tax rate is given 30%. So tax on operating income. So here what we are doing, we are deducting tax out of operating income. Normally we know that from operating income or from EBIT, first we deduct interest and then we deduct tax. But here we want the net operating profit after tax. So from operating profit itself, we are deducting the tax. So operating profit before tax is rupees 1 lakh, less tax rate 30%. So tax on operating comes to 30,000. That is a 30% of 1 lakh. That comes to 30,000. So net operating profit is equal to, net operating profit after tax is equal to 70,000. So this is the first component which we have got. Net operating profit after tax, 70,000. Now check out balance sheet, out of which we can find out our second component. Check out balance sheet. In the balance sheet, equity is given by rupees 20,000 and debt is given by rupees 10,000. So total capital or total liability side, 30,000. Fixed assets, 20,000. Net working capital, 30,000. So total assets, 30,000. Total liabilities, 30,000. Total assets, 30,000. From this balance sheet, we want our second component, that is a capital invested. And capital invested means equity plus debt. So that is equal to 30,000. And thirdly, our third component is weighted average cost of capital. But that weighted average cost of capital is not given to us. But what is given to us? These are the specific cost of capital. Specific cost of debt is 8% and specific cost of equity is 10%. With the help of this, first we will have to find out our weighted average cost of capital. Check out. So these are the three components. Net operating profit after tax, 70,000, this one. Capital invested. Capital invested means equity plus debt. So here in the balance sheet is given, equity 20,000, debt 10,000. So equity plus debt, capital invested is equal to 10,000. So this one we will calculate over here. Check out, now we have to calculate weighted average cost of capital, because we have got net operating profit after tax, we have got capital invested. Now we want weighted average cost of capital, which we have to calculate with the help of this information. This one, cost of debt and cost of equity. So cost of debt is given to us 8% and cost of equity is given to us 10%. Check out, here it is given, cost of debt 8% and cost of equity 10%. Now amount of cost of debt, which is given in the balance sheet. Check out, debt 10,000, equity 20,000. So debt 10,000, equity 20,000, total capital is 30,000. So this is third one. Now what we want the proportion, or that is also called as a weight. Weight of each capital on total capital, or proportion of each capital on total capital. So first I will find out the proportion of debt. Debt amount is rupees 10,000 divided by total capital. 10,000 divided by 30,000. So proportion comes to 0.33. The proportion has come to 0.33. We'll take it into two decimals. Now, same on the same manner, the proportion of equity, that is equal to amount of equity, value of equity divided by amount of total capital. That means 20,000 divided by 30,000, that comes to 0.667. I will just take it into the two decimals. 0.67. These are the proportion, or these are the weights in the total, hamesha ek rahegi. Now I want to find out the weighted cost. Weighted cost of each source. These are the specific cost of each source. Now I want weighted cost of each source. So how to find out? that is a specific cost 8% multiplied by weight 0.33. That comes to 2.67%. Again, check out specific cost 8% multiplied by its weight 0.33. That comes to 2.67%. Cost of equity. Cost of equity specific cost is 10% into weight 0.67. So 10% into 0.67, that comes to 6.67%. ये दोनों के हमको टोटल लेना है 2.67% plus 6.67%. So total weighted average cost comes to 9.33%. So weighted average cost of capital is 9.33%. Now here we have got all the three components. Net operating profit after tax 70,000. Capital invested, that is equity plus debt. Sorry, wrongly I have written as 10,000, it is 30,000. Capital invested, equity 20,000, debt 10,000 is equal to 30,000. And weighted average cost of capital is 9.33%. Just we have calculated in this our working note. So simple calculation of net operating profit after tax. The formula is now we have to calculate economic value added. EVA is equal to net operating profit after tax minus capital invested into weighted average cost of capital. So net operating profit after tax, how much? 70,000 minus into bracket capital invested. Capital invested. So capital invested is rupees 30,000. Capital invested is 30,000 into what? Weighted average cost of capital is 9.33%. So 70,000 minus into bracket 30,000 into 9.33% is equal to 69,067. You can cross check it. So you can just solve it arithmetically. 70,000 minus into bracket 30,000 into 9.33% EVA is equal to 69,067. So this is economic value added. You can just check it out. Economic value added. Or just again, once again, we can cross check it over here. Is equal to 70,000 minus into bracket 30,000 into 9.33% bracket complete. Sorry, amount is 67,000. So wrongly, I guess that's why I thought to recalculate it, because earlier I have considered here as a 10,000 as a capital, so which I made the correction. So this is the wrong amount. The correct answer is 67,201. So correct answer is 67,001, because wrongly I have mentioned earlier the capital as a 10,000, but which is a 30,000. Here also, if you may have noticed, it was written as a 10,000. Here also it was written as a 10,000. That's why there was a mistake. It is very sorry. I apologize for that. Now the actual capital is 30,000. Once when you get 30,000, the EVA is 67,201, which is the correct answer. I hope you understood this concept, EVA, which is very simple, but very logical. Thank you very much.